Be My Eyes now has a Windows app. You aren't able to call volunteers or use specialized help. However, you can use Be My AI. They recently did an update where you can customize keyboard shortcuts now. Let's go over how it works, all the good, and all the things I wish could be improved. Hi everyone, this is Carrie on Accessibility, where we talk about tech and accessibility. If you're interested in that type of content, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you can be notified every time I upload a video. Let's jump right in. I'm going to share my screen and let's talk about this Be My Eyes Windows app. You can download the app from the Microsoft Store or go directly to the Be My Eyes website. I will have links down in the description. I already have it Be My Eyes installed. I'm just going to open it and you will have to sign in. Once you log in, there are four main buttons on the Be My AI tab. There is Describe My Screen, Take a Picture, Describe Picture, and Describe Clipboard. If you activate Describe My Screen, it will take a screenshot without the Be My Eyes app. So once you click on it, it minimized the Be My Eyes app really quickly and then took a screenshot, and then Be My Eyes showed on the screen again. Then it had to process that screenshot and now it has a description of my desktop because that was what was happening in the background. From there, you can ask a question. And if I say, describe in more detail, I can press enter, or you can tab to the send button, or you can just click on it. And there we go, it had an answer. Your questions will be in white on a dark or a medium blue background. This one is pretty easy to see. Then any answers is white text on a black or gray, very dark gray background. It's pretty easy. I'm gonna go ahead and click back. The next one is take picture. That will use the webcam to take a picture. Now, one issue that I have here is there is no way to switch your input method. So if you have different webcams, there's no way to change it. The third option is describe picture. That one opens the file explorer and then you can select a picture you want described. The last one says describe clipboard. So if you already have an image in your clipboard, maybe you took a screenshot or maybe you copied an image, you can use this and it will describe what's in your clipboard. Right below that, it says keyboard shortcuts and it lists out the different keyboard shortcuts. For example, describe my screen is Control Alt H, take picture is Control Alt J, describe picture is Control Alt K, describe clipboard is Control Alt L. Now I have NVDA open. I can press tab.
Describe my screen left parent. Keyboard shortcut Alt plus Ctrl plus H right parent button.
So it will announce what it is and it will give the keyboard shortcut.
Take picture using built-in camera left parent. Keyboard shortcut Alt plus Ctrl plus J right parent button. Describe picture from file explorer left parent. Keyboard shortcut Alt plus Ctrl plus K right parent button. Describe clipboard left parent. Keyboard shortcut Alt plus Ctrl plus L right parent button.
If I press tab again after the fourth button,
my AI tab selected 1 of 2 level 1.
And now I'm going to press right arrow.
Settings tab 2 of 2 level 1.
There's settings.
Selected.
I'll press enter. And now I can press tab.
Customize keyboard shortcuts link.
We can customize keyboard shortcuts.
Sounds enable toggle button pressed.
We can enable or disable sounds.
Terms of service link.
There's terms of service.
Privacy policy link.
Privacy policy.
Send us feedback button.
Send us feedback.
Help center button.
Help center.
Lock out button.
Lock out.
Facebook link. Twitter/link, YouTube link, Instagram link, back button, settings tab selected 2 of 2 level 1.
And some social links. Those are just the controls. You're going to have to use object navigation to navigate if you want to read all the extra information and headings. If you're using JAWS, you can use virtual PC cursor, and if you use narrator, just have scan on. If you go into customize keyboard shortcuts.
H, back button, back tooltip.
Now, if I press tab,
settings tab selected 2 of 2 level 1, Alt plus Ctrl plus H, press the change button.
it gives me the keyboard shortcut that I would like to change, but it does not announce what that shortcut is for.
Alt plus CTRL plus L, press the change. Alt plus CTRL plus J, press the change. But Alt plus CTRL plus K, press the change button.
You can use object navigation.
Describe picture. Alt plus CTRL plus J, press the change button.
It would be really nice if we did not need to use object navigation, because I feel like this is an advanced or maybe intermediate advanced feature in NVDA, and I feel that not a lot of people use it or know about it, and so it could be a bit challenging for certain people. I feel that if they just added it to the message, press to change, and said the label, that would be extremely helpful. Unfortunately, if you're using screen magnification, you may really want to change your describe my screen shortcut, the Control Alt H, because it does not work if you're using magnifier. A few points here. It's a little bit hard for me to read this text, the white on blue, particularly when I put my mouse over it, because then it's white on a lighter blue background. That's just not easy for me. Also, the text size, there's no way to control the text size, which may not be the biggest issue until you're actually trying to read the text. And when there's a long description, it can be fatiguing. I have to zoom in quite a bit, and I wish there was a way that you can have it read aloud without having to use a screen reader. I mean, Gemini has it, ChatGPT has these features where it can read aloud, but an app that's made for the blind and visually impaired, it doesn't have that feature. It's rather disappointing. Something that would also help me is if this edit field was easier to find instead of having just the bottom border, if it had a border around the whole thing. That's definitely a smaller issue, but it's still something that I wish could be improved. A few other things that I wish it could do. I wish we could call volunteers and then share screens or share a picture with them. That would be super helpful. And I wish there was a history. Once you describe something, you have to press back and that's it. You can't review what you've already described. It'd be also very nice if we could have multiple images described as well as PDFs. That would be awesome. And once video capabilities of ChatGPT 4.0 and other models are available, I would really love to see that integrated into this app. There you go. That is the Be My Eyes Windows app. It can be super helpful. I love this feature. Again, there are improvements that they could totally do, and that would make the experience so much better. But this is definitely helpful. The links will be in the description, like I mentioned before. Let me know if you use it, if you like it, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe. If you find this type of content helpful and you'd like to support my work on this channel, please consider becoming a YouTube or Patreon member. Thanks everybody for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.